So since it's Lucky Bhaskar, so I want to test luck first.
Ah, this dumb luck I don't have.
Dumb luck you don't have.
I'm generally fortunate and blessed, you know, but like,
okay.
Finding like a dollar, not I want.
No, you don't. That's not your vibe. Let's see, Meenakshi.
Okay, what do I do with
this? Let's see if you can aim and throw in,
in
the cup.
Oh God! Why do we always
Meenakshi
end up playing?
The cup.
Yeah. So let's.
Is it how many?
Okay, do we get like three chances?
No, I'll just cut and put the ones that work.
I love this game.
See?
Oops.
That's cut.
Okay.
She's got three already.
Four. So there you go. Lucky Bhaskar will be a hit in five languages.
Woohoo!
That's how luck goes. So first, Lucky Bhaskar, before I start, Macha, you're the retro king of India.
Mm-hmm.
How are you always in a period? Why do all period cinemas come to you first?
I've actually begun to now fear directors thinking that if you don't bring something period to DQ, like he might not say yes. So it's like, is it period? Let's take it to him. I feel like how much I fight these things. Like I was trying to fight love stories. I try to fight retro period films. Uh-huh. But eventually, if there is something really authentic and beautiful in that story, I can't be like, I don't want to do this
because it's period
or because it's a love story. End of the day, we're here to tell great stories, right? And that's what I love most about cinema. Like, I want to tell the most beautiful stories. So, if I'm meant to be period in for most of my career, and if I have to have some filmography with the record of most number of period films, so be it.
I think you already do, just say.
I think already I do, yeah.
So what do you think? Have you seen him in other period stuff? Doesn't he look like he walks out of a period, his hair, the way he looks, it's just perfect.
You should be saying this.
I think
as to why I'm looking like this is also partly because of him.
No, but honestly, I think he's like a cardboard cutout, right? Like how they say, these are the ingredients we need in a character that should look like this, that should fit the thing. He fits it all. And I think I now understand, like, working with him on this film and, like, seeing footage and whatever we, you know, the scenes we do together, I feel like it's just so easy for him to glide into any character that it is. And I think he's blessed to just be able to fit into that retro vibe because it's not everybody's cup of tea. I've also understood that. Not everybody can suit into that. And he's just blessed with that modern space. He's blessed with that retro space. And I think very few have that. And I think he's one of those. So
before getting into your film, I have to... Like, I'm usually the
Thank
most...
Thank you, by the way. I took all these compliments and I'm sitting there like...
Just
soaking
facts.
It in.
So usually in life, I'm like the most secure human being.
Mm-hmm.
But the only thing I'm insecure about is hair, mm-hmm. Okay? And
you have a good head of hair.
You know, this is a fixed head of hair.
I love the honesty.
But when I see him, like, usually when, like, women take a long time to get hair, like, I saw him getting his hair done once. I was like, Macha, how do you have so much hair? And you're older than I am in some strange way.
I am, yeah.
It's but just a Malayali thing. Is it like
it's a Malayali
Kerala
thing?
You have, like, I don't know, I've seen all the people who are from Kerala have amazing hair.
It's in the coconuts, Macha.
Possibly.
Think it's just that,
possibly,
right?
Possibly the
oil. So tell me, how did Lucky Bhaskar start? What did, with you? How did Venky land up, speak to you?
I think how it all just panned out together in this one space was, I think it was Venky's call to kind of think. I was in the sort of list of, like, you know, they say the short lists of things of people who might fit the role of Sumati when they were looking into that. And I did a look test and I didn't hear back from them for a month. And I was just like giving up, thinking, I think this is not happening, so let me just move on with my life. And it just took that long for them to take that call. I don't know how it happened. So then suddenly, this one day, out of nowhere, I think it was after a month, I get a call from Venky. And I'm in Bombay and I'm sitting and he's like, hi, just wanted to tell you, congratulations, welcome on board. I was like,
which Venky is this?
Yeah, like, he just started the conversation on that note.
Why
and
are
I'm
you
like,
congratulating
I was just thinking, what is he saying? Like, what is he talking about? It took me like a minute to kind of just understand what was happening. And I was like, oh, you mean Lucky Bhaskar? I was like, yeah, just wanted to let you know that you're on board. I was like, oh, okay. That's literally how it happened. And then the next thing I know, we are here doing the puja, starting the film in the next week, and it just started off like that. So, yeah.
But you know, in full sort of praise to her, the fact that Lucky Bhaskar is what, your fourth film, fifth film?
Yeah, Telugu, yes.
Yeah, so, and starting out, and the first thing in the film, like a big part of the film is there in the trailer, is that we are playing a married couple with a child, and the child is 6-7 years old, and there is no way that Meenakshi is old enough to have a child of that age, unless you, but the fact that she had no qualms about that, I thought it was so, like, just refreshing, you know?
Yeah, today it's hard to say you don't want a kid, you want, yeah.
No, as in, even me, for that matter, like, I think I started to play dad after I became a dad.
That's, you know, interesting.
Yeah. Till then I was like, okay, maybe I was pushing that little 20-something year old, or like, not college, but like single guy role to an extent. But once my daughter was born, I was like, okay, now, you know, it's legit. Like,
it's legit, yeah.
Like everybody can believe it. I don't want to take it away from anybody who's, everybody wants to create whatever image they have, or they hold on to it, and because I feel like I did the same. I love the fact that she believed in the idea of the film, and she loved the character of Sumati, and she was like, so what? Venky was like, you know, but you're playing a mom, and there's a child, and I feel like that's exactly what you said, right? You said, so what? And there is not a single sequence in this film where I see Meenakshi playing Sumati with Ritwik as his son, as Karthik. There's so many sequences of them together. They kind of enter together, or they're interacting together, or they're there in the house. And it feels so organic, and it feels so real. And I saw her putting in the effort to bond with him. So yeah, that takes a lot.
Thank you.
And so this is you played dad before?
Yeah, I have.
And this is your oldest kid in that sense?
No, I've had older kids.
You had older kids?
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. Clearly, this is your first time
this
playing mom.
First time
playing mom. So, okay, I had a very funny thing because Adusesh was my son first in Bahubali.
Yeah.
So straight. It was like, that's what I got there first.
But you know, historically, they've all done that. Like, I feel like dad's played father to Mohanlal, sir.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So
wow,
I feel like that generation of actors came from a school of almost like theatre, right? You play all kinds of roles. You can play a woman, you can play a 70-80-year-old man, you can play a teenager, you can play anything. And that's the challenge.
Yeah.
See, like Venky is somebody in Telugu we know for extreme detailing of characters.
Right.
Like, I'll sound like a cliche Telugu guy, but usually in Telugu there's a largeness to commercial cinema.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And that's the beat of cinema that is mostly accepted. But there's a handful of filmmakers that make a commercial film also have art house sensibilities where detailing of characters is perfect. You see production design on the film, it's perfect. You don't see anything that's off character. And Venky is one such. And earlier you spoke about the production design of the film and how much of detail it was. So what are the finicky things of Venky and how does he start?
I think this I relate to completely.
Okay.
I've always felt you can tell very believable, real, logic-based stories and believable characters, which it's almost like considered art house in a lot of mainstream cinema. When you go into that level of detailing of real life, or portrayal of real life. But at the same time, I feel like you can make that commercial. You can tell it not a larger than life way, but you can mount it in a certain way where there is scale, there's entertainment, there's I'm saying extraordinary things can happen to ordinary people. And I feel this film is so much of that, so much of extraordinary things happening to this one
ordinary
common
man,
ordinary man and his family.
Yeah.
Ordinary people in that sense. But I think the genius of Venky, I'm glad he's not here, so I can praise him, is that he seems to get the pulse of the people in this film. And there's a whole variety of characters, there's a whole spectrum of characters. And it's not like everybody speaks Venky's voice.
Mm.
It's not that everybody speaks his language. There is enough detailing where each person seems their own. If somebody is of authority, then they are of authority. If somebody is of a somebody who's failed his 10th grade, and he will obviously speak that kind of a language. And I love that Venky is able to write those. There'll be days that I'm fighting with him about some random thing, and then he'll give me the scene, I'll read it, and I'll be like, oh, I can't fight with you because
this scene is so good.
You can still write this. Mm. Like, I mean, your views on life or something I might argue with or debate with you on, but like when you give me a scene, I feel like it is so organic and it's so real. In fact, the biggest fights I've had with Venky on the film is post-shoot, is an edit. Huh. Because he obviously has a time limitation and a runtime limitation in his head.
Right.
And I'm like, how can you take the scene away? It's so beautiful, it's so real, it's so organic. And you know, like, isn't it hurting you to like trim this and sort of lose the essence of it or something? And he's like, no sir, I have a larger story to tell. Mm. And I can't really pick and choose. So I want everything to be there, but like this is the best
this
way.
How
to,
you get
yeah,
it.
And but it's been such a long time since I fought with a director to lengthen a film. I'm always fighting to reduce.
Yeah.
Like, this is almost 3 hours, bring it down, cut 10 minutes, cut 15 minutes. And that is, I think, as producers, we have that sense in our head, right? But this is the first film where I'm like, I think I can afford another 5 minutes. Mm. You can give it another 10 minutes. Let the film breathe. It can afford it because it's so organic.
So like Venky, every time I see him, he's like this quiet, coy guy, but he's got very definitive views on life and the way characters should be.
Yeah.
And you won't expect that's coming out of somebody who's set in that tone or that tonality of speaking.
Sure.
How is he as a director? Like, how does he direct people? How clear is he?
I think that's, I don't know how he does it.
No.
He's the exact opposite of what he writes.
He's like, the exact opposite of what he writes?
The
is
majority
that what
in his writing is...
So you're
is
saying...
So, so, I mean, I'm awestruck sometimes as to how he explains the character should be. When in real life, he's just talking about model cars and I'm like sitting there.
He's talking about model cars?
Yeah, I'm not kidding. That, like, literally asking.
I don't know if I had that influence on him somewhere.
Yeah, model cars, 100% this guy would have said something.
It just
takes off and I'm just thinking, I can't believe
I created
this
a monster, so he's...
Yeah.
That's what he talks about.
That's really? All he talks about.
A lot. And then Meenakshi is like, but we have... And then she just sit there in the background.
But he has this childlike energy about
he
anything
does.
That's
yes,
new.
He does.
He gets excited with... Okay, I'm sure this car wouldn't have been in his head.
I mean, he had a collection of some cars from his childhood. Uh-huh. Like, I think he really got into it.
Sure.
I think when he
like
came
you.
To narrate to me, he saw my collection in my house or something. But it went berserk during this film.
It's crazy. But also, what's beautiful is that he's so talented. And I have... there are very few directors who really portray women in the most authentic, organic and beautiful way. And I think Venky is one of those.
That's awesome.
I was so apprehensive initially because I was like, he's like, I don't want layers of makeup on you. I don't want you to even look like you have makeup on you when you're in the house and all the house scenes. And I was like, I don't know if it, he's like, just trust me on this. Don't.
It looks so beautiful. It
does.
Looks so real.
Whatever you've
it
seen.
Does. Yeah.
I don't think we've ever seen Meenakshi like this.
Yeah.
And, oh, no doubt.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm sure we'll see
so.
Different shades of you, different
so
characters,
but
like,
yeah,
I don't
so
know
far.
If we'll ever see
yeah.
a Sumati.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
a Sumati lives in a certain era, in a certain time.
So I think it's the most authentic version of me so far that I've played in any character. And I was actually very scared because this is getting too real. And I was not sure if it's how it's going to be. But I think he just, when I saw it and I was like, he just knows what he's doing. He's so good.
There's not a single scene that we get, like when we get the sides. We're prepping for it or reading it, that you cannot believe fully.
Yeah.
Like, we are performing with full conviction because it feels like a life lived.
True.
So, I know a little bit about him. Every time he gets a role, he somewhere lives that a little bit and a part of that role becomes him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, during the period of that film.
Yeah.
Like, and it happened over time. Like, I've seen him during Kota, there is a certain aggression in the human body, in the body itself. I've seen him through Lucky Bhaskar, I've seen him now with Kanta.
Yeah.
In some ways, like...
Yeah.
What is it with you? Does part of that character stick with you? Or am I right or wrong first?
I guess it's always there playing in the back of your head. Right? Uh-huh. Like, and if I think if you're on a certain look or a certain hair or beard or whatever. Like, I think
that
I think
energy of that person sticks
there,
with you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How about you? Did some parts of Sumati continue being with you?
No, absolutely. The major part of Sumati being that she's a mother. That's something that I obviously don't have any real life experience with. So I really had to kind of dig deep into that aspect of my character that I was playing. But apart from that, I think I'm a complete director's actor. So I give into the process of what he wants me to do and how he wants me to be, because he has the whole, you know, the whole movie in his head. He knows what's happening. I probably don't know how I, you know, would see that. So, and also we don't shoot in a linear way. So I don't know what's happened in that. So I think I trust him fully with the way he's like, you know what, I think she's going to be in this space now. So I don't think too much.
But sorry to interject, but did you think you referred like your mom or like the mothers in your family in some form?
Yeah, so just the mother bit was something that I knew that I had to kind of work on a bit. And literally the only example that you'd be having is your close ones that you've seen around you, which is my mother. But apart from that, I don't think like for other characters, there's not too much of like homework, I would say.
I feel like every time you came, because I mean, this film we shot over a year.
So you shot over a year?
Over a year.
Oh my God,
that's
great.
Like, I mean, not entirely Venky's or Vamsi's.
Yeah, breaks on and off.
I had some health issues.
Yeah.
But I feel like every time you came back to set, you were very happy to get back into Sumati. Right?
Yes. So that's one thing. Nice. This is one set and one character that I have absolutely enjoyed to the bits. Like, I cannot tell you the energy that I get and that I have. And I feel like it just kind of spreads. You know, that energy on the set is something that I've not seen anywhere so far.
So apart from the both of you, who are the other actors that are larger part during shoot?
I mean, the kid.
Ritwik was so good.
Yeah.
There's not one retake I can think of.
Because of him.
We would forget lines, you know.
We'd forget lines. Oh, we'd mess up.
Yeah.
In fact, there's a sequence where he's asleep and both of us are talking and I say something and she reacts loudly and he wakes up. But between takes, for setup or whatever, we're taking time. And he's always lying there with his eyes closed. And he could have very easily fallen asleep for a child of that age.
Right.
But he was there.
But as soon as they call action and as soon as it's his cue to wake up, bang on.
Nice.
So the one, I think, I feel like there's one time where he messed a line up. We're all like,
how could you?
Yeah.
What? How could you?
Did you mess up a line? And he was like,
he's like, is it that wrong?
And we all put him on the spot. We're like, oh my
finally,
God.
Finally, one mistake with this kid.
True.
But he's adorable and he is so well prepped. Knows all his lines, knows all his beats. Knows
very
all
hardworking,
his,
disciplined.
Hardworking, such a good kid.
Yeah.
So I loved the experience of working with him. But I think the entire cast, as in not just the home situation, like even the bank. Every single cast member there, I feel like we all almost live like that is our workplace and we all have roles to play. There's a gentleman who plays the security guard. Every single day of shoot, he's already there in uniform. And when I'm walking in, he'll salute me. And we have so many interactions in the film. And I feel like in the most distant shot where he's there in the background, he's still standing there. Like,
and you know,
it's amazing. And every other character in the bank, for me, and we almost operated in that same manner. Some 45 days we shoot in the bank set. So every day at 6 p.m. when they call pack up, we'll all leave the bank together.
So it's like, so, you know, you're like almost bank employees
like
all
that.
Exactly. So
getting
like,
out of the
like,
same
like,
place.
Like a factory, the bell or whatever rings and everybody exists together. We'll all pour out of the bank like that. I've never had these kind of experiences. So I remember there was a day when I think we finished early and all the bank actors.
You know, you were going to say all of our bank employees.
All
the who's going to come out of your mouth?
So they all kind of got into regular clothes and they all want to take photos and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, wow. Like, this is how all of you look like, because they, when in period attire and, you know, like work clothes of that time, they're all very like formal looking and you know, like hair done up and, you know.
Correct.
And then now they're like cool, young, colorful,
peppy,
hair open and all this stuff. And I was like, wow, like I can't imagine all of you like
all of these guys like
beautiful.
See, like when, as soon as I heard from, actually first from Venky about what Lucky Bhaskar was, right? Like just the fascination of taking money from a bank and just going away was just a happy idea.
big spoiler. Huh?
No, I mean, that's what I, like just bank, money.
Sure.
And I always wanted to loot a bank, like in my life. And you like, what is that energy? Like, there's a writer called Sridhar Raghavan, who's a friend of mine. He's there, every time you can take money from somewhere, some institute, it'll be a blockbuster because all of us want to do it.
Because we're conditioned to... are we allowed to reveal this?
Oh, no. So it's not? Like, then we'll chop it in.
Okay.
Vingy will take whichever piece he wants.
Sure, okay.
They'll put a piece
I think our conditioning, right? Yeah. Our conditioning is so much to behave and do the right thing and follow the rules and the law. and abide by it and, yeah. and not really stir up any kind of hornet's nest. So when we see films where you, or when I see true crime dramas of any type, you're always wondering, how can you do that? Mm. You know, wow, like it really takes some guts, or like it really takes sort of some dismissing of your integrity or your understanding of right and wrong to go and do this, you know? And I think that's what we find kind of heroic.
Heroic.
Like, wow, this takes another kind of guts. This
guts
takes another kind of like bravery to do this, because the rest of us are so boxed by conditioning.
Yeah.
So I think that's the fascination.
Okay, when I meant bank and money, I actually was talking about Nagavamsi. So Vamsi is right. He's a dear friend. I worked on with Bimal Naik. I did a film with Sitara, and he is so different from all the producers you normally see, in a classical sense.
For sure.
So he had something which now became very viral and popular. I have to talk about it.
Sure.
He said day one is going to be 100 crores, and that's how he's beginning his campaign for this film.
just to make it clear, in 13 years of my career, almost 40 films, I still haven't hit 100 crores. So if this does 100 crores day one, I will be the happiest. I will probably be like Vamsi. I'll have a framed picture of you in my home.
But tell me, how is it with Stara, with Vamsi, Chinmay, all of
you know,
all of them?
No, they've been lovely and they've been very supportive of the film. But I remember there was one, I feel like we were maybe 30% of the film. And Vamsi is very confused. So he's not the kind of producer that's like meddlesome, like he doesn't overly interfere.
Yeah.
But he does, you know, visit from time to time to sort of show his presence and make sure like you know that he's around. And that's good. I think that's healthy as producers. If you're there every day, you know, like a lot of producers sit there all day to seem like, you know, the clock is ticking and, you know, like
there's that nervous energy.
Correct. Because you're like, if we go over, but he doesn't do that. Like he comes from time to time. So one day he wanted to meet me and he's like, sir, is everything going as, do you think it's going okay? Because, you know, this is not a typical massy commercial film fight and dance and songs and all this stuff. But we're still going, this many days, we're still shooting so much. You sure it's okay? And I was like, Vamsi, this is not a type of film that even I've attempted, nor is Venki. And I think, I've done one heist film before. And when you do any, should I reveal heist film?
We'll just block this and we'll just beep it. They'll think it's something wrong, bad we're talking.
But I'm saying, okay, certain genres of films need a certain amount of shots and angles and stuff to either increase pace, decrease it, slow it down, speed it up how you want in edit. So we do need n number of shots, especially in certain sequences. So I was like, I do understand what Venki's, there's no wastage, we are not traffic.
We're not just blowing up.
No, we're not. So he's like, okay, sir, you're sure? I said, yeah, I'm sure. Okay. Then beyond that, there's no
conversation
about this, which I liked. Because he was trying to understand it. I think as a producer, he's seeing us shooting and shooting and shooting and shooting, and he's like, this is just some, okay, bank, okay, you know, house, and there's some, done, you know, like, this should be a quick film without so much effort.
On paper, the idea of...
Correct.
It's usually a strange thing when we assume that if there's no song and dance or there's no big action sequence, you feel like the film should get over fast.
Because you can break down song, dance and fights.
Yeah.
You can be like one song 4 days, this song 5 days, this fight 12 days, whatever.
Whatever, correct.
There is a calculation.
But for drama, you don't know how to
drama,
break it.
Drama, you don't know how to do it. I think we're facing the same
thing. We're facing
Kanta.
This.
With Kanta. We're like, huh.
Oh, this is how long it takes? Okay, no problem. So now this film is out on the 31st of October.
Yeah.
And it's out across India in 5 languages.
Yeah.
Sure. Now, what is your expectations of each?
I'm beyond, I think, these past 2 years have been the slowest in my career in a very long time.
Hey,
I usually do at least 3 films. If you see my contemporaries in Malayalam, they're all at like 5 films, 6 films. My dad is at 5, 6 films. So when I'm like 1 film a year for 2 years, it's almost unprecedented. Like there's no,
so here, but in Telugu, they think you're an actor who does films very fast in Telugu.
I need to speed things up. Because I signed the film thinking it's a 3-4 month film. It's taken
a year.
So I think for me, the joy, the excitement is the fact that I'm coming out with a film after 14 months. So, and irrespective of how it fares in each of the languages. I think we've made a good film.
Nice.
And I think the subject is very Indian, very universal in that. I think 80% of India is either a Bhaskar or knows a Bhaskar or relates or connects to a Bhaskar. I think for me, when I first heard the script, what I connected with it, I was like, if some decent percentage of the audience walks out of the cinema halls at the end of the film feeling like they are Bhaskar in some way, we have a winner.
You have a winner. Yes. So Dil, who's a Bhaskar in your life? Or have you seen Bhaskars around?
I think we all know Bhaskars in our lives, in some form or the other. In like my dad is some 5 siblings, my mum is some 3 siblings, and obviously their kids, their extended families, and there's always been only one movie star. I'm the second in that sense. And so all of growing up, we've always seen different members of the family struggling in some form or the other, especially financially. And I think that is all of Bhaskar's story, right? He's, every month I feel like he's a little in a negative balance. Like he'll make X, but his expenses every month are X plus so
plus,
much.
Yeah.
And that's his struggle. And I feel like so much of our country historically has always been like that. I think it's been a lot better of late. Since liberalization in the past 20 years or whatever. But there are still people that struggle on a month-on-month basis. So, which is what I think I love most about the film.
About the film?
Yeah.
Tell me, who are Bhaskars in your life? Have you seen Bhaskars around you?
I think I've grown up in a very normal government services. My dad was in the army. And I think even though you get to have a very comfortable life, I do remember having the best travel experiences and memories in our Maruti, the four of us just going in, traveling. And,
Which is so relevant to
it is. So, you know, I feel like it's, I have all of those memories etched in my mind. Like, I can still, you know, remember it so clearly about all of those things growing up in that space wherein my mom would have to bargain with the sabzi wala also on how it is. But it's a typical, you know, like middle class space. That's what I've grown in, where education is given the most importance, you know, focusing on things that will probably stand you long term. I remember I would be buying my books and that'd be saved and passed on to my brother, because we won't be buying the other ones. We'd be like, why buy it if he's going to go into the next, you know, like this, that's literally.
It happened with me too, just that I didn't use the book, so I just went to my sister straight.
Sister, yeah.
They're fresh books.
So that's what, I remember my mom buying a little size, one size extra, like for us, for our school uniforms, knowing that we're going to fit into it probably next year as well, it's going to go in. So, you know, those small things that work in, and I've grown up with that thing. So I know those things and how the smallest of things make so much of an impact in a normal government services or a middle class family. And I think that is what I could relate to the most when I was listening, when I'm shooting, when we are all hearing those scenes. It's so relatable because I have grown up with those things. And it just felt so nice knowing that it's on screen, because I could relate to that and be like, you know, we also do this. Do you remember this in the Maruti or stuff like that? So it's so beautiful to have this story. And I think this is one of the reasons why this film is so special to me.
So I have to tell you something about army kids. I know you're an army kid and you've lived in different places in the country. So like they always used to have a sense saying, okay, you guys are civilians, we're army kids. They were like treat us different. Is that how you grew up too?
I mean, it's
saying,
just...
you guys are civilians. I'm like, what does that even mean?
It's
like,
yeah,
we're here protecting you.
Yeah. Yes.
Is that
yes.
the sense that you...
Because, you know, we like to call ourselves, or most of us, I remember it's army brats. Brat is not just a brat. It's like born, raised and transferred. So you literally...
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
what is that?
I mean, because you are born and you're raised in a certain way and you keep getting transferred. I mean, because of your dad's job. So you are not just born in one place and you're not just raised in one place, but you're transferred in so many places across India that you kind of learn, even, and I'm a very shy kid. Growing up, I was extremely shy and an introverted kid. It took me so much of time to get used to knowing that it's going to be a new school after 2 years, a new house, a new place. The moment I get used to the place, it's going to be a different place altogether. So, you know, I think I take pride in the fact that it kind of forces you to get out of your shell. And learn to be on your own, because every 2 years is going to be a new place altogether.
Wow, so I'm saying, so class 1 to 10, you shifted like...
I think I shifted, what, like 5, 6 schools?
That's crazy.
It is.
That's crazy.
It is.
But also, just imagine, like the fact that there's certain security we all face, that we all enjoy, especially like south of India, we're pretty far away from the borders and stuff. and all of our army personnel that is like protecting us, imagine the stress their families go through.
Oh yeah.
You know, imagine the fears they live with. It can't be easy.
It can't. There's a different
and we just take it for granted.
Fully so.
So which is so I think it's fully justified if they when call they, us
civilians. Civilians in yes.
You guys
deserve to say whatever you want.
I remember most of my childhood, my dad was not even with us. So I remember having an evening 5 o'clock call. I know that call is going to be from our dad. And it's just going to be like a 15-minute call. How are you? How's everything? How's your school? All good with my mom, with my brother and me. That's it. And every day, exactly at that
time. But you would all wait for that call.
Yes. So we just go running and like, today I'll pick a call. Amazing. You know, so it's those memories. And I truly am so grateful for all of that.
So your sense of discipline, all that comes from
comes from that. Yeah, absolutely. My parents.
So she's like punctual on set.
Never late even a single day.
Yeah. Yeah.
As in, I feel like she calculates for traffic, she calculates
everything.
For RFC, she calculates for whichever location she's there.
Yeah.
Where did you all shoot most of this film? I knew a lot of it was set and set up.
Almost entirely on sets in Aluminum Factory.
Yes. Okay.
Which felt like home in some way because...
With the mosquitoes and everything
but
else.
But we were going there every day. There's a routine to it, which is so rare in what we do.
Yeah.
To have a routine to going to one place, yeah.
True.
Yeah. That I totally understand.
True, yeah.
So tell me, what do you want people to take back from Sumati once they watch this film?
I think I want them to take back a part of themselves. Because I can guarantee you, when you watch this film and when you watch Sumati, living her life, I think that every mother, every wife, every daughter, the sacrifices, the, a lot of compromises, sacrifices, a lot of giving up on your own goals to be able to live. And that's not in a way wherein you're saying that I'm sacrificing. You want to do it. You willingly take that decision. And the courage and so much of passion and the strength. I think Sumati is the definition of every woman. Yeah. Every woman. Every woman. And that is what she stands for. And I think she holds her ground throughout in the entire film with every choice and decision that she's made. And I love that about her.
Nice. There was a lot of grace and dignity.
It is. Yes, she has that.
Okay, now if I say take home, I'm saying you've always picked stories that are unique. Mm-hmm. They've always created some kind of thought when you get out of the cinema. What would this have? What do you think we would have?
But I feel like you've done the same. Mm-hmm. I think the one thing you, me, I'm sure even Meenakshi connects, like resonates with is the fact that the stories are bigger than us. The stories are larger than us. The stories will outlive us. And I think what we're constantly seeking is to find those films and those stories and to create that cinema that is gonna outlive us, our grandkids hopefully can be proud of the choices that we made today.
Yeah.
At the age that we're at.
True.
But this is all I love to do. I feel like I love to hear as many stories as I can and find the most authentic, original ones in that. And then put everything into it to kind of tell that story. But also when and it's not quantifiable the kind of audiences that connect to cinema.
True.
I cannot say we're making this film just for a Telugu audience. Mm. There have been films of mine that have resonated with somebody in Turkey or somebody in Bangladesh or somebody in Japan. I don't know.
That somebody like you on the street.
I'm just saying. I've grown up.
You don't do that.
I don't like disrupting people in general. I don't. I'm not obnoxious. But the beauty of cinema is I feel like it can transcend borders. It can transcend language. It can transcend
back in time,
ages. So I feel like if there's something, there's so much of just human drama in this film. And I feel like if that connects and resonates with people and they make it their own in some way, and I feel like if it's a world that they want to keep revisiting, then we've done something right.
Yeah.
See like every time way before I was an actor, right? Every time I saw something in period, mm-hmm. I always used to get excited that cinema is probably the only place you can recreate a time that you've never lived in.
Yeah.
True.
I just feel like you've recreated that time like a full timeline now. You have from 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, you're going across.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, so I've kind of sat down at some point and tried to analyze this. And there was a time in maybe the late 80s or early 90s when my dad did some of these sort of epic period dramas in Malayalam. talking of our folklore and stuff like that. And that time also, those were big budget films.
Right.
And but still, they could kind of afford to make those films.
Mm.
Then we went to the 90s, where
social became more.
Not even social. I feel like the business changed in such a way. This is pre-satellite, where somewhere the costing was not working out.
Mm.
So you were then devoid or sort of deprived of anything period or anything large scale,
right,
for almost a decade.
Yeah.
And I was like, these are going to be big, ambitious, where you need a producer of that courage to kind of recreate
amount
something like that.
Recreate, yeah.
So when I became an actor, I never imagined that I could ever be part of a large scale period drama or a period film.
I think it's your childhood manifestation, dude.
Somewhere.
That just made you this.
So when a Mahanati came my way, I was like, wow. Like, I felt like a kid going to Disneyland for the first time. I didn't think this ever happened for me. Every day of that set, like, you know, we met Shivam just now, but like, every day of that set, I'd be like, I'm like this. And I feel like that's never left me. So like, anytime you think you can sort of bankroll a period film with me, and if I can make that happen, maybe I'm doing something of some service to my younger self. I don't know what it is. But it gives me so much joy and sort of confidence that like, hey, this film is still bankable, even though we're putting in this kind of money and effort into creating this era all over again.
Such an honest, nice guy, you know, this guy is?
I know.
No, I'm, like, this is like totally true. Like, when I wanted to start my career back as a producer and I said, okay, how do I make it? He's probably is the only guy, and I'm saying it with such joy, and I don't think I've said this to you ever. I feel lucky and blessed that this guy is the hero of the movie that I'm making.
Wow.
Really.
That's such a big thing.
Such a joy, man, to work with you. The fact that the ethic of storytelling that you have, the way you sit with your character and just be that person.
True.
It's very, very hard in today's time where somebody holds that ethic to stories.
Also, speaking of, you know, luck and lucky Bhaskar, how fortunate are we, you and me? You are some third generation, I'm a second generation actor and producer for that matter, to find a story and then be able to put that together and make cinema out of it.
True.
We could be two kids or some children playing some kind of storytelling role play that children do.
True.
But we get to do it for real, at large scale, with, you know, big money being spent, where people also have conviction that we can do this, we can pull this off. So you and me coming together after I don't know how many decades of friendship, and we're creating something together, I think that in itself is such a blessing.
So all that stuff next, but this is the amazing team of Lucky Bhaskar. Vinky is not around, but I'll get him also in front of the camera for you guys very soon. But all the best to you,
Thank you.
I think this is going to be an amazing 31st October for you guys.
Thank you.
Hopefully.
So I'm saying all the luck of Lucky Bhaskar should be with you guys.
Thank you.
And yes, like, all of Telugu cinema is going to root for you. And when Telugu cinema roots, the whole country hears it.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely.
And that's how things roll here.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely.
So all the best to you, DQ, and all
Thanks.
The best
thank
to you,
thank
Meenakshi.
You, thank you.
Thank you, Chief.
Lucky Bhaskar on the 31st of October.